Good afternoon, everyone. This is meteorologist Brian Adams here, giving you your weekly weather briefing for today, February 28th, 2022. Starting off with a look at the satellite here, we do see a beautiful looking storm system sitting out over the northeastern Pacific with an atmospheric river aimed at the Pacific Northwest and Southwest Canada. Now, will we begin to see any influence from this system? You'll just have to stay tuned. Now, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention what feels like the 8,000th round of Santa Ana winds for the month of February alone so far, but fortunately, this one is on its way out the door. Winds would be decreasing through the afternoon and evening hours, and fortunately, we won't have to be dealing with any more significant Santa Ana winds. It seems like through at least the foreseeable future here into early next week, so we can definitely appreciate the break from the winds here. Let's take a look at Tuesday, what we can expect for tomorrow. We do see high pressure settled up to our north over east central California and western Nevada, so that'll set the stage for some pretty significant warmth for tomorrow, as you'll see here in just a little bit. Here are the high temperatures for Tuesday. Many areas from the coast, across the mountains, and even into the deserts, well above seasonal averages. We're talking high temperatures 10 to almost 20 degrees in spots above normal high temperatures for this time of year. So definitely a warm one tomorrow. Let's take a look at Wednesday. We see that high pressure then that begins to scoot eastward and settles over the Rockies. So not as much influence from high pressure as we'll see on Tuesday. And then if you look up across the northwestern United States and even into northern California, we do see a front on the way along with some pretty significant rain chances and mountain snow chances across their areas up there. So let's take a look at what we can expect temperature-wise on Wednesday. Again, it's still going to be a little warm on Wednesday, not quite as hot as what we're expecting tomorrow, Tuesday, but still several degrees above average. But you'll see that's kind of segueing into what we're finally going to see some relief in terms of cooler temperatures and potentially even some rain chances for Thursday and Friday. But first, let's just take another quick look at some of these temperature trends. This graphic was actually posted yesterday, but I want to draw your attention mainly to the temperature trends as we go through the end of this week and then into the weekend as well. You see, you know, that roller coaster like dive that's really, you know, going to be occurring across pretty much all of our area starting tomorrow and then lasting into the weekend as well. We're going to be significantly cooler compared to tomorrow. And then as we look at rain chances Thursday evening and Friday, hey, we finally have been, you know, we keep begging for more and more of these rain chances, and they're finally going to make another appearance here, mainly starting up Thursday evening and then lasting through Friday as well. Going to be spreading from north to south starting Thursday evening with also potential for some mountain snow across some of the higher terrain, mainly as snow levels fall during the daytime on Friday. A little early to comment on specific rainfall amounts and especially on snow amounts, but stay tuned for additional updates. So now let's take a look at the next 6 to 10 days for as far as the temperature outlook goes. Definitely on the backside of that cold front, going to be well below normal as we go through this weekend and into early next week. So definitely some cooler weather on the way following this storm system Thursday and Friday. And then as we look at precipitation chances in particular here, there could still be some lingering showers Saturday and Sunday as that front is slowly pushing eastward away from our area. But otherwise, going to be generally pretty normal for early March, just now equal chances for, you know, maybe drier or maybe some lingering showers. A little murky to tell there on the backside of that system, but right now it looks like Saturday, Sunday would be the most likely time to see any lingering precipitation. For any additional information, feel free to check out our webpage at weather.gov/sgx. Check out our Facebook page and also follow us on Twitter. Thanks. Have a wonderful day, everybody.